This summer, the Fantastic Four will face their greatest challenge. A mysterious being from space possessing incredible power known as the Silver Surfer.
Oh, that is cool.
Now, join us for a behind-the-scenes look at the comic book origins of the Surfer that served as inspiration for the makers of the new film, Fantastic Four, Rise of the Silver Surfer.
Who in the world would think of a guy traveling through space on a surfboard? If I'd have had the thought, if I'd have had the imagination to think of it, I would have discounted it immediately.
When Jack brought the drawings into me, there was some naked guy on a flying surfboard. I said, who's that?
The first comic book that I ever bought was Fantastic Four 49. So one of the reasons that I do comic books is because this was such an amazing fantasy storyline.
Well, a lot of people out there are going to get the Christ on the surfboard thing and roll their eyes and want to walk away. But me, I'm like, yeah, Christ on a surfboard, you know?
It was just, to me, it was like the golden age. It was like I was alive with Michelangelo and Leonardo. These guys were coming up with stuff that was way, way out.
This was one of the great characters of the Marvel Age of Comics. The Fantastic Four looked up one day and saw the silver guy flying through space. Turned out he was the herald of Galactus. Galactus was a world-eating entity that was coming to eat Earth, and the Surfer had been sort of forced to be the guy who would find the planets for the world-eating entity to eat, and now it was going to be Earth. Fantastic Four was able to put a stop to this, but Galactus then imprisoned the Surfer on Earth for having not followed through on his end of the bargain, and that set off what became a major character in Marvel Comics. This was 1965 when he first appeared, and a sort of alien being who didn't belong on this planet was a popular concept. I really did think he was a great creation of Jack Kirby and Stan Lee.
I came up with this character, Galactus. I wanted somebody who was like a demigod and who actually destroyed planets. And Jack said he should have a herald who flies ahead of him to find the planets. I thought that was a wonderful idea, almost tragic. I fell in love with him, and I said, I want to use this guy. I want to use him a lot.
He and Jack Kirby had created the Silver Surfer, but it was still a character that Stan really liked. Stan believed in the creativity of the company. He was not a prima donna, so the Surfer didn't disappear completely, but it was still known that it was Stan's character. When they wanted to do a regular series, John Buscema became the artist, and that became more of a Shakespearean tragedy. Stan always liked Shakespeare and that sort of operatic human relationships thing.
I decided I'd let him be very philosophical, and I'd let him be the way somebody from outer space might be if they came to Earth. And he'd wonder about all the strange things that human beings do. And I tried to get a little of whatever my own philosophy might be spoken through his lips.
That Surfer and humanity element to it that I think is what really makes the character unique. The cosmic being who comes down to Earth, sees us with different eyes, and yet responds to the inherent decency in humanity despite all the horrible things we do. And that's the tension, I think, that makes the character great.
5 years of that stuff based on a crazy idea, and Stan not only was allowing it, he was complicit in it, he accepted it. And we knew it, and we were all sucking it up.
The physicality of him is a large part of who he is. I mean, it's just him and he's silver. And to me, it's that limitation, I think. I mean, the physical limitation, but also the mental limitation, in that to my mind, he was sort of an average guy. I mean, possibly with more heroic grandeur somewhere in there, but he wasn't some special person necessarily. He was just somebody who stood up to Galactus and said, if you don't eat everybody on my planet, I will do whatever you want. I was very taken with this individual, probably the most alone guy in the universe, exiled from his people, covered in silver, set out into space. He was alone on a human level, but he was also alone on a physical level, being in the vastness of space with the great emptiness and the vast distances. When I started writing and I started reading up on space for the first time, I mean, really, and grokking the concept of just how far it is between things and how what's in between them is basically emptiness and darkness. And that I found interesting. I thought that the psychology of that, who would this guy be if he really existed? Who would he be? And that was a consciousness that nobody else had and really appealed to me.
The big thing I wanted to do is actually do the death of Galactus, with Galactus having to face what he's done. So that, and all he really wants before he dies, while I'm building up this whole big cosmic epic, it wasn't just Galactus and Silver Surfer talking to each other, you know? But what he really wants is the Silver Surfer's forgiveness. You know what I mean? That's the only soul in the universe that he cares about. Because one thing that was always unstated there was that Galactus on some level cared about the Surfer and respected the Surfer. So the idea that Galactus is going to die and all he wants is the forgiveness of the Silver Surfer before he goes for his sins, you know?
When my first issue has published, he gets off the Earth and he gets to go back out to where he belonged. I mean, not only was it getting old, not only was it really old that he was stuck on Earth, but also there was so much he could do once he got off Earth. I mean, he's a space guy. And all the stuff about meeting the various entities of space that Marvel had created was all right there once you could actually get at it. That book sold. I mean, I think that was the key, that we all liked him. We all thought he was a great guy, but until he could really do everything that he could do, you couldn't really get everything out of him that you could. And people really responded to that Silver Surfer run.